Hey guys, Shurum here, and today I'm going to be testing the Bugatti Veyron at Golden Max in multiplayer in Asphalt 9. Please consider subscribing if you haven't already, and be sure to check out my Shurum Clips channel, as well as the Purple Team Discord. Links to those will be in the description, and I hope you enjoy the video. A while back, I made a Golden Max test drive in this car, and today I'm finally going to review it in multiplayer. And here I very nearly wrecked on those rocks. I think I was just a millimeter away from it. In the season where I tested this car, I gotta say, I did have a lot of fun driving it, because it's one of those cars that is not really that easy to drive, and I'll explain why in a bit, but it is really rewarding if you can learn how to drive it and play in it well. And the thing is, it just does not drift that great. The radius is not the best, but the biggest thing for me was just how low its speed dropped. We see a race later that's going to be on Cairo with the 360 degree turn, where we can really see that in action, but we'll be able to see it in just this race here as well. So we've gotten a decent sized lead ahead of cars, which is narrowly closing now, because around these turns we just lose a decent chunk of speed and people are able to catch up. That Huayra there went right over me somehow, just because I was in shockwave. I'm pretty sure I didn't get knocked down there, and he was right on my tail throughout the entirety of this end section of the race, although we are able to pull away at the last second and take the victory. Throughout the races in this video, you will see some of the contrast between cars that are more agile but with lower top speed, such as the Huayra and the SC18 there and the Aperta. I recorded these races in the same season I recorded the SC20 races a while back, by the way. Just never got around to uploading this video till now. And also the Aperta, I guess, in that list of cars that are lower top speed but more agile. And then we have the Veyron here, which is definitely not as agile of a car, but it does have a higher top speed of around 270-ish miles per hour. It goes about as fast as the Fenner. And so on tracks like this one on San Francisco is where it really struggles a lot, because there are a lot of turns where it loses a good chunk of speed, and because the nitro efficiency is not very great either, it can't get up too much of a high top speed after them. And thus, this Aperta is staying ahead of me, and this Huayra behind me is catching up. But now comes the part of this track which tends to balance things out, because you have this really long straight section toward the end here, where this car can start catching up, because it can build up a lot of momentum. You guys know the drill. Now, the end of this race was kind of crazy, so I landed and I bounced back up for some reason, almost flew right over him at the end. Unfortunately, he got the win, but we are only a single frame behind. In our next race, we're going to be on San Francisco again, and again against a bunch of Huayras. The Huayra was by far the most common car that people used in this season. I just think because it's so well known for being such a great car for multiplayer, and it really is. It's just, I think, still a little bit overrated. Not as overrated as cars like the Corvette, though. Anyways, in any case, I did not really see many other Veyrons at all. I think people just found them somewhat difficult to drive, because honestly, I can completely understand that. In almost every one of the races that I played in this car, the other cars would get ahead at the beginning, and I would only be able to pass them if I got a good long straight section where I was able to maintain a speed above, say, 250 miles per hour for a decent amount of time, which thankfully throughout this section I was able to, and because of that I was able to get ahead. Again, being in shockwave and touching some other cars in the air had shockwave, and I think it was only because I was in shockwave that I did not get knocked down. Thankfully though, toward the end of the race, we begin to pull away after going high on this barrel around the final bend without hitting the outside, somehow in this car, and I'm not entirely sure how, and we come in first. Next up, Nevada, where we have another Veyron actually, finally, as well as a 570S, a couple of Apertas, a couple of SC20s. This was actually one of the most diverse races that I played in the season, and there weren't actually any Huayras for once. How about that? So the car that typically put up the most competition against me was the Aperta, because that car is, I would say, a little bit better than the Huayra overall, and they always put up a really good fight. And you have to remember as well, I was in Legend League above 1800 rating in all the races that I played in this car, so my competition in terms of player skill was also very good. Again, on Nevada here, we see me getting behind toward the beginning, but then catching up throughout this very long section leading up to the tunnel, where we have the big momentum bridge part, where you can just gain a lot of speed on the jumps. Then, I again narrowly miss getting knocked down by that Aperta, like, pushing me against the side of the tunnel. We come out here, getting further and further ahead just due to the higher top speed, and at this point it looks like it should be a slam dunk. But then, you have to remember, the turns at the end. This car slows down so much around the turns, this Aperta almost managed to catch up and pass me toward the end. Thankfully not, we're able to accelerate enough after the turn to come in first place and beat this Aperta, as well as another Veyron who came in third place, which honestly is a pretty good showing considering I did not see too many of them. And here we have one more in this race on Cairo. Now, Nile River has always been one of my favorite tracks in Asphalt 9. I think part of that is just because of its mostly straight nature throughout a lot of it. You obviously have the 360 degree turn with it that kind of balances things out a little bit, and honestly has been... Okay, well, I completely forgot. It's been so long that I recorded these races, I completely forgot that stunt there happened. But anyway, due to being fairly straight for most of the track, it really lends itself to cars such as this one and provides a good testing ground to see what it might be able to do at its fullest potential. And we see that because I'm able to gain a lot of momentum throughout this section and keep it even onto the bridge, I'm able to get pretty far ahead, and for the first time, I think in the video, the other cars go off the map, which is really a testament to what you can do in one of these cars if you're given a long enough straight section. And fingers crossed, Buenos Aires should have, according to Gameloft, some straight sections. It's gonna be a mix, as they said, because they don't want to do a track that's all straight or anything like that. I would take that with a little bit of grain of salt after Auckland, but still, pretty optimistic on that. It sounds like it will be a fun track. So there, toward the end there, you can see that we slow down to around 120 miles per hour around that turn near the top, which is not great, and is why the speed loss of this car, I believe, is one of its biggest disadvantages. And the other cars, because they have better handling, were able to catch up a bit throughout that section, but we had gained a big enough lead that it wasn't a problem. And here, I almost thought I was going to fall out into the water, such as happened to me many times before. Thankfully, I did not though, and we're back squarely into second place, catching up on this, yes, you guessed it, an Aperta in first place. Now I guess it's time for my general review about this car. Honestly, I had a good bit of fun driving it. It's not the easiest car to drive by any means, but it presented a very fun challenge where, yeah, you might have to struggle a little bit to get some good wins, but it is very capable if you can get the right tracks and you know how to keep it at a good top speed and you take the right routes too. Like going over to the left there is faster in cars such as this one because you can wall ride and shockwave up to a higher top speed than you could if you go to the right after going around that hairpin turn and going down to a very low speed. So guys, thank you all so much for watching. Please like the video if you have enjoyed and consider subscribing for more Asphalt, Forza, and other games content. And I will see you in my next video. Goodbye!